Where's that blue tub? Do we have it around here?
I don't see any blue tubs. Okay. You must have already hid it in your secret spot.
See the bone? Did you see the leg bone in there?
Nope. Not yet.
Okay.
What are we doing now?
We're readjusting the giants. We're moving them up so we get closer to the face.
About 50 feet, so we're losing the amount of water pressure we had. We just weren't reaching out and getting exactly where we needed to. So we're moving everything up a little bit, adding an extra section of hose. Since it's been raining a lot, water level's high, so everything's good. We just decided to kind of reset everything. The mud is thick. We got the Terry stamp of approval, the leg bones out. Come on back in time in our Pleistocene tunnel. Let's go. Covered. Step two, we gotta wash it. Jordan, help me.
How long has this one been exposed to you guys? When did you see it?
So, all we originally saw was this shape here going back a ways. We didn't know exactly the depth of it. It's been exposed for maybe about a week, but it's just been so frozen in, which would explain if it was just a regular leg bone, it would have thawed out by now. But being so wide, it was still frozen. Heavy with all this mud on it.
Yeah, that's a lot of weight.
Jordan's taking the classic rock approach. I'm taking the finger approach. One thing I've learned is this mud is really rich in minerals, good for your skin. Actually really good to eat sometimes. Just kidding.
This piece of ice
just popped out of it. So cool. Eat it.
So.
Oh, she ate it. Does it taste like ice age? Take a bite.
It's like our water from home.
You know,
iron filled. You got Giardia for sure.
This is what we like to call patient zero.
Wow, Jordan, you cleaned it real nice.
This bone was just stuck in that bone.
There's this little crack in here.
This, it's another piece of bone that was just stuck right in here.
I just pulled it out.
This animal was eaten. Look at that, chunks of it ripped out, like a huge portion of it.
Oh,
that's gone.
Yeah.
That's like meat, bone, ripped out. All you can feel is how lumpy and bumpy it is.
Oh, no more stuff happening over there.
Like some other stuff laying down back there.
I know, I'm waiting for him to get out of there, and I'm gonna go in.
Terry.
She wants to go in?
Yeah.
She's on deck.
So when you get in the back part of the cave, there she goes. Terry pulled out another rib bone, mammoth rib bone out of the back there. We have another leg bone that's exposed, that's down and under, and another one of these rib bones that's really far under, so we're just not gonna mess with them right now. We're gonna kind of wait for it to be a little safer, maybe, and then we'll go in there.
Let me see, Jordan. Okay. Stay there. Flip it over.
Showed up today thinking we were gonna find a leg bone, but what we really found was a scapula, a mammoth scapula, way back in our tunnel. And Terry also pulled out a rib bone. Overall good day, but we do see another leg bone that's tucked away back there. It's still frozen in, so originally we thought we'd only find the one leg bone. Surprise, it's not a leg bone, but there is one back there. Stay tuned.
Did you just find that?
Yeah.
Cool.
I got this here bone and that there hole.
Nope.
Whoa, awesome.
Did you just find that in the cave?
I did. It was under a cut bank. I like the coloring of all the bones that are in there.
Nice find.
It's a nice find. It's gonna be a good day. We're gonna find more.
Yabba yabba.
Nope, that's what they mean.
We're hosing.
Influencers in the wild.